Hello, you're back here at channel NoneAndAllNow with another episode of Dear Dude. Today on Dear Dude, I am going to begin by saying please subscribe to channel. Click little boxes. It's like making religious donation without your own money. But now I am going to move forward into today's episode of Dear Dude, and here we go.
Today, some person, actually not today, in the last couple of days, some shit-eating fucking spiritualite on Facebook has posted a question. Not exactly for Dear Dude, but I am going to take you there anyway, because I think it is make good episode, no? Okay. Wait, check. Now, here we go. What I am saying about this person's question, this is what it was. Dear Dude, what do you do for the world? It was a weird question to ask, because actually the reason that I was even engaged in the thread in the first place was to make a statement, a political statement, one that is incredibly unpopular and incredibly uncomfortable. Yet, Martin Luther King, Mahatma Gandhi, Samuel Clemens, who is Mark Twain, by the way, and Albert Einstein all had this in connection with each other. They were ferocious proponents of this philosophy and idea that I was taking it upon myself to also emulate and keep up the good work. And this person had the gall, because they didn't like the way I said it, to just pretend like I am some ignorant waif wandering in the wilderness, completely devoid of any kind of wisdom, therefore totally lacking compassion for others and any sense of myself that is dignified or worth anything. Right. This person had the gall then to, after assaulting me in this manner, by basically telling me I am not even like a bug on the ground, ready to fit to be smashed into bits, right? I am nothing to her. This person then asks me, what do you do that's so good for the world? I love spiritual lights, all right? The New Age is freaking awesome. I don't want anyone to ever get me wrong there, okay? I love everything that we have produced through spirituality. Even teachings like egolessness, I think, are appropriate. And someday, maybe I will take a serious trip down that. But for the most part, they're incredibly confusing to people, and they set just another ivory tower standard where people start to think that they're better than everyone else. And they don't actually go out and do what they talk about. They say, oh, I love people. I have this overwhelming sense of compassion for all things. Let's have a healing circle with a bunch of trust fund kids who all are riding around in Range Rovers and living in paradise, because life's so hard drinking and playing volleyball all day long. Yeah, right. That's what I'm talking about. When there's kids in their town fucking legitimately sleeping in the bushes and smoking methamphetamines to stay alive. And they look at those people and they say, oh, how miserable they must be. It sucks to be that. I'm gonna go get another tofu burger. That shit doesn't just drive me nuts. I actually think it's quite ennobled, and fucking all you vegetarians out there who aren't doing anything other than that for the world, just, you know, you don't eat meat. Good for you. You're fucking awesome. Vegetarianism is definitely a consciousness that is in line with pacifism. But here's what I'm saying. Every single person who begins to engage in this spiritual path of peace all of a sudden does the exact same thing that I've always been accused of doing to everyone, which is being a total fucking asshole. Oh, well, that's a paradox, isn't it?
perhaps it's time to go into another explanation of Tai Chi.
But Tai Chi speaks for itself. If you don't understand it, you don't understand it. So go learn to understand, huh? Maybe read book like Lao Tzu. Anyways, this is what I'm saying about spiritual lights, and it leads into another question that we can bring into the mix here at Dude on NoneAndAllNow. This guy one time asked me, what's heavy work? I'm a light worker. First of all, this is the first thing he said. I love everyone. I am totally compassionate. I have no ego. I am Deepak Chopra and Eckhart Tolle rolled all into one. And then he started talking about the crackheads who work outside of this place that he works at, or that they live outside. I'm sorry. They live there. He worked there. Okay. So the crackheads who live where this guy works are filled with suffering. There's nothing to do for them. Everything is fucking hunky-dory for me. I have all enlightenment and everything else. But these people out here suck. They're miserable. They're smoking meth. They're smoking drugs. They suck, you know? Oh, they're so ruined. They ruin everything. They make life miserable for everyone. So, that's kind of like what I'm saying here. You know? And I said, yeah, man, I'm not really into light work. I'm into heavy work. And he's like, what's that mean? Heavy work. And I'm like, heavy work? What's heavy work mean? Yeah, man. Well, it means that I go out and I get right next to those people and I put my arm around them. And if we need to bleed together, we fucking bleed together. And he pretty much ended that conversation right there. But I know he's still there. Maybe he's even going to watch this video. Hey, what's up, man? We're still friends. Don't worry. I'm talking shit about you in front of the whole world. But you don't know what knows who you are. And I don't mean anything bad for you. I don't even know you. You don't know me. Don't get lost in self-absorbed trip on, like, whether or not the dude is not cool with you. Okay? But I'm just saying to all you people out there, I am bringing up nastiness and things that you don't like to look at, and that is for a reason. I'm doing it to you on purpose. It's not because I'm filled with these things. I'm filled with overwhelming compassion and love for everything in this universe. But the reason that I am so ugly and so full of fire and so full of hatred and so fucking spewing it out on everyone all the time is that your world is disgusting and ugly, and it's because human beings are cancerous and that they have ruined everything in this world. You have made yourselves miserable, and you are all wandering around on this place. If you are awake, pretending like you are asleep, and that is awake, and those of you who are awake, you are fucking only just zombies going around. Look at my car, look at my rings, look at my clothes. And fucking then you come on Facebook and you post little stupid pictures about positivity and non-ego. None of you are actually out there in the work. None of you are actually out there in the field. None of you are actually out there helping people, dragging them across the finish line. And then you look at those other people who are actually doing it. The priests who aren't molesting kids, and they're not give a shit about what the Pope tells them. You look at those other people. These fucking Buddhist monks living on Tibetan's reservation who are fucking lighting themselves on fire and fucking they're willing to fight, but they're all about peace. And you don't know them, you don't understand them, you have never experienced anything like this. You are not a monk. You are not a fucking practitioner. Even if you are, most of you in the United States, you're something like a reverend or a minister or something like that. That means you're totally hands off, you only show up on Sunday. I've seen your fucking churches, they're always closed. They don't feed anybody, they don't house anybody, there ain't nobody there sick in sanctuary. There ain't people that are having fun, there ain't people that are singing together, they're not growing vegetables. Some of these places have fucking community gardens, that's great, but it's not enough. And I am out there every day, shaking people down and saying, what are you doing? And that's what I'm doing for the world, I'm doing it constantly, I'm doing it everywhere. And on top of that, I'm doing something else. I'm fucking lessening myself, I'm failing on purpose. I'm giving up everything that I am, everything that I could ever be, and everything that you think I should become. To be a fucking ignorant, babbling pig in front of the whole world, crying, stupid, bang my head against myself. That's what I'm doing. I don't even eat. I don't even use money. I don't take anything. I just go out and I help people who have less than me. That's what I do. What do? You don't do anything. You fucking drink your coffee and you fucking wake up in the morning, you have another banana, and then you go to B of A and you cash your checks. You go and you say, oh, it's okay, I don't care that people are using predator drones to kill fucking goat herders in other countries. That's just part of the world. But kids bullying each other on schoolyards, that's got to go!
You people are fucking disgusting, you don't know the way, and you're not spiritual at all. I'm the fucking king of all the spiritual things here, and I know my own, and you're not one of them. Now, to those of you who are, and if you're listening to me, you might be asking yourself, what the fuck do you want us to do? And I'm gonna tell you, I have an idea that will revolutionize this planet, and will give it a facelift like no other, and it will be done by next week if I get people to help me. But I'm asking you now, I've been here long enough, I look exactly as I am, I come from exact line, everything about my life is total synchronicity. I'm the fucking genuine article, where are my armies, where are my people, where are the people I want to have me save everyone?
There is no one outside my door, just people who come and they go. They show up for a little bit and then they quit. That's all I can get.
I'm asking you now, what are you doing for me? What are you doing for transformation of your world? Do you want to shift or not?
That is my question for you. And after you are fucking asking yourself that, come back for another episode of Dear Do here at Channel 9909 on YouTube, where I'm going to show you exactly what I think and feel about this subject and discuss exactly these points. I'm going to record this now, so it will be coming at some time. You won't even have to wait full day. Oh, ciao, champ.